Hey, did you hear about our next stop? It's a world called Penacony. I hear it's a beautiful, dreamy place. I'm so excited. But Pom Pom said the banquet we were invited to is still a little ways off. Huh? Is that my phone? Must be the group. He can't just ignore Branya. Let's go to his room and talk to him.
What the? Is this? Upend the ancient sea and return to old ground. It's a letter for Dan Hung, but...
Did you see it yet?
Yes, I saw it.
Then why didn't you reply? Ronnie is a good friend of ours.
I'm sorry. I'm just not in the mood for idle chat. There's been a lot weighing on my mind since the Lo Fu. It was tough on the spirit.
Dan Hung... I'm the one who should be sorry. I was being too pushy. You're right, you went through a lot on the Xianzhou. Take all the time you need.
Thank you for understanding. It's great that Bellabog is able to host a celebration. I hope your trip goes well. Say hi to our friends for me.
Okay, rest up. You're not allowed to miss the next Trailblaze expedition.
I'll be there next time.
He won't budge, huh? Looks like it's just the two of us then. Pity. He's gonna miss out. We never get the chance to go on a stress-free adventure. I know, but it's still a shame, don't you think? If only Himeko could come with us. Maybe not. He's still wheezing from the trouble we got into on the Xianzhou. You didn't notice? At his age, he might not appreciate the extra... excitement. Why don't we go ask Himeko to tag along? She might be up for an adventure. You've been on the Express for a while now, but you've never gone on a trip with Himeko before, right?
Hey, Marge. That's a big smile on your face. What's the good news?
Himeko, there's a celebration coming up on Yorillo 6, organized by the Supreme Guardian, and we're invited to go take in the sights and sounds. Dan Hung won't be going anywhere for a while. He's still resting up, so wanna come with us? I mean, considering how you helped us out with Kokolia, I'm sure Branya would be happy to see you.
So that explains the grin. You're excited about the celebration. Thanks for the invite, but I'm afraid my hands are full right now. Please send my regards to the Supreme Guardian. Make the most of the festivities. You've earned it. You two and Don Hung did help save Yorillo 6, after all. I'll be sure to join you guys next time.
Navigators really do have their plates full, huh? Seems like it's just you and me this time. Let me go pack some stuff for the trip first. Come and find me when you're ready to set off. So, what do you think about my new dress? Pretty neat, right? It's actually not new. I just never had the right occasion to try it on. This kind of event doesn't come around every day. Why shouldn't I dress for the occasion? You're not really gonna wear that same old outfit, are you? Let's just pretend I never said anything. As long as one of us is making an effort. Pajamas, hot water bottle, pom-pom doll, that should be everything! Wow, that was fast! Well, I thought since Pom-Pom can't leave the Express, bringing a doll with us is kind of like taking them trailblazing! I was just taking a look at Mr. Yang's records, and it seems like Yorillo 6's average temperature has warmed up quite a bit. I wouldn't call it livable just yet, but things are looking up. I'm so happy for Branya and Zila. Ready to go?
Galabar. 700 years. It's never too late to pick up the tab.
Brr! How do people living in all this snow celebrate anything? One thing's for sure, though. Where there's a celebration, there's bound to be food, right? Wait a sec. That person over there. That doesn't look like a Silvermane Guard uniform. All in black. Surely they're not... IPC? On this world? Am I going... The Interastral Peace Corporation. Who else? The one whose insignia is pretty much everywhere? You still don't remember? What about Findy? That's one of their products. Oh, and the Interastral Peace Broadcast. You know the one always being played on the Express? Never mind, it's not that important. The important question is, what are the IPC doing on Yorillo 6? There's only one way to find out. Let's go ask. I've always... Hi! Do you work for the Interastral Peace Corporation? Or are you just dressing fancy today?
Boss, encounter with two unknowns. Want me to take them out? Over.
Take us out?
Take them out? Just hang tight for a second. I'm on my way. Don't do anything stupid.
Glad to make your acquaintance. I'm Topaz, an investment expert from the Interastral Peace Corporation. I'm here on Yorillo 6 for a special business assignment. You'll have to forgive my colleague here. People skills aren't his strong suit. Please don't take it to heart.
Phew! You scared the life out of me! We're here for the celebrations. We're not looking for more conflicts. Oh, right. We should probably introduce ourselves. I'm March 7th, a passenger of the Astral Express. You may have heard of it? And this is my friend and fellow passenger.
No kidding. I could tell you weren't locals from a mile away, but I didn't expect to run into two nameless here. Fate is such a curious thing. I heard that Urillo 6 only stepped out of the Stellaron's shadow thanks to the direct intervention of the Trailblazers. Surely, you two aren't.
Huh? Jeez, can you be a little more humble?
I never imagined I'd run into living legends here. Must be your lucky day, huh, Numby?
Wow, Miss Topaz. You're really young for an IPC executive. That's impressive.
More good luck, I suppose. But it's not as cushy as you think. Scurrying from one side of the galaxy to the other. Going wherever businesses require me to be.
Huh. Your job sounds pretty similar to the Express crews. Oh, Bronya moves fast. The crisis is only just over and she's already opened talks with the IPC.
These talks aren't exactly what you might expect, but I have to agree. The Supreme Guardian definitely knows how to govern a city. That's the reason I'm here on Urillo 6, to meet with her. Miss March, you said you were on your way to Bellabog festivities, right? My apologies for delaying you both.
Don't be sorry. It's not like we're in a rush. Wanna come to the city with us? The snow plains are freezing, and it's easier than you think to get lost out here.
Thanks for the concern, but I'll manage. It's my first time on this world. I'd like to take it in its vast, iconic snowscape for just a little longer. Who knows? Maybe we'll cross paths again during the celebrations. Oh, here's my contact information. I don't usually respond during work hours, but...
Wow, I actually managed to get an IPC executive's phone number without even trying. As if anyone would ever believe...
You two make a cute pair. Anyway, I'd better be on my way. See you next time.
The universe is huge, yet we somehow stumbled onto the same path. Fate truly works in mysterious ways, don't you think? Come on, let's head into the city. Wow, there are people everywhere. Are you sure we're in Bellabog? Now to check out the main event, the food! Come on, keep up! Is that Payla? Looks like she's teaching the kids again.
Next, I'll be introducing the history of the museum. Everyone listen carefully, okay? Bellabog's History and Culture Museum was founded 600 years ago and was originally built to memorialize Supreme Guardian Alyssa.
I'm so hungry. I wish I could have a red sunset salmon right now.
It was built to memorialize Supreme Guardian Alyssa Rand and also...
Guess what? I heard there's gonna be a Silvermane adventure camp opening in the Overworld soon. It's gonna be super awesome.
Also, those who sacrificed their lives in the war against the invaders 700 years ago.
Miss Payla, Peter is falling asleep.
Enough. From now on, no whispering allowed. If you don't want to have any homework later, you'd better start listening.
Sorry, Miss Payla.
That's better. Now, where was I?
Well, I never knew Payla had a strict side. sec! Isn't that Wallace up ahead?
Norbert, why don't you tell everyone how you were released from jail so quickly? Selling cultural relics and impersonating Silvermane guards are both heinous crimes.
Well, it was all thanks to my uncle, you know.
Ah, I remember. Your uncle is Minister Knoll. He heads up the Department of Transportation.
yes, you knew that too?
You're shameless, Norbert. Not to be rude, but if I were thrown in jail, I wouldn't possibly ask my father to bail me out.
Do you think I wanted to? I'm not the type of person to abuse my status.
Well, I don't really know about that.
Get off my back, will you? I had to deal with hardened criminals in jail. Now that I'm free, my supposed friends are ganging up on me.
Looks like things are getting heated. I think we'd better get out of here.
Master Rossi, may I inquire?
Hey!
Woo! Thanks, everyone! Hope you're ready for a great show! Let's get started!
Heartbeats will shake me,
so rules can't break me.
Crank the sound and let your soul be free.
The lightning strikes riding off the wall. Let yourself fall into it all.
Who'd have thought just taking a stroll could be so tiring? Say, I think we should probably pay Bronya a visit. After all, or we could go check out some other fun stuff elsewhere.
You know what I mean.
I understand the difficulties that this world is facing, Supreme Guardian. Bellabog's current financial burden cannot be pinned on you, nor anyone else for that matter. However, objectively speaking, since Bellabog has existed as an independent entity to this day, its debt cannot simply be written off. Oh, it looks like we have some visitors.
Bronya! And Topaz? You're here too? I guess you've already started your business talks. We'll get out of your way if...
It's no bother. We've pretty much wrapped things up already anyway. Please consider my plans carefully, Supreme Guardian. If Eurela 6 wants to rebuild its connections with the rest of the galaxy, your credit record with the IPC will be of great importance.
You've made yourself clear, Miss Topaz. I'll require some time to consider my next course of action.
Naturally. However, while you're deliberating, my colleagues will need to carry out some operations in Bellabog. I hope that your subjects in the underworld are cooperative. I'm sorry our business got in the way of a reunion with old friends. I'll get out of your way.
Everything all right, Bronya? I didn't know Miss Topaz was so intense. She seemed nice when we met her.
It's good to see you two again. Welcome back to Bellabog. I planned a special reception, but I had to deal with an unexpected guest. The lady you just witnessed, she claims to represent the IPC. There's no need to keep either of you in the dark. To tell the truth, I have too much weighing on my mind right now to even think about the Solmworm Festival. Since you've already made her acquaintance, I needn't explain who she is. I'm sure you've heard pieces of Bellabog's history the first time you visited. The Legion's invasion 700 years ago, how the Stellaron brought about the Eternal Freeze. It seems that much of Bellabog's history from that time was buried deep beneath the snow. Those memories were lost and weren't passed down to the subsequent generations of Supreme Guardians. Topaz shared with me the story of the Stellaron's descent upon Yarillo 6. How the original outsiders stationed here foresaw the impending disaster and chose to leave in large numbers. Among those outsiders were several investors from the Interastral Peace Corporation. Before they departed, they did something noteworthy. They sought out architects who refused to leave, those who insisted on defending their homes. The IPC provided these architects with significant funds to aid them against the coming disaster. It was with those funds that Bellabog was able to construct its immense walls. Even the initial funding for the development of the first batch of automatons was drawn from the same pool.
Wow, that's a pretty incredible story. So, does that mean Topaz's business here is to collect a debt from Bellabog?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
That's ridiculous! And what's with the timing? What took them so long to get here? If it wasn't for us eliminating the Stellaron, they'd have nothing to collect. It's obvious they're just trying to take advantage.
According to her account, the repayment period agreed upon by the architects and the IPC investors was 280 years. However, less than a century after the loan was taken out, the connection between Yarillo 6 and the rest of the galaxy was completely severed. The IPC deemed that the disaster had caused irreparable damage and that there was no civilization left to reclaim the debt from. As such, they considered the owed sum permanently lost. It wasn't until the Stellaron crisis was resolved that the IPC discovered that Bellabog had survived.
And that's when they sent Topaz over to collect the debt.
And the interest. An astronomical amount. I don't even know how to read such a long string of numbers. Before you both arrived, Topaz warned me that if the payments were delayed, the IPC would give her the authority to employ strong measures.
Oh, I had no idea things were like this. Here I was thinking the IPC had come to rebuild Bellabog, not extort it. Yeah, we have to help Branya out. The IPC is too big and powerful. The Bellabogians won't be able to resolve this problem on their own.
You seem to have a deeper knowledge of the Interastral Peace Corporation than I do. But if the records are accurate, and they truly have a presence throughout the galaxy, the IPC could crush Bellabog like a bug if they wanted to. I'm glad you're both here. I know you came for the festival, but now... Now, I must ask you and the Astral Express for help. Do you think you could persuade Topaz to reevaluate the situation? The Express's reputation precedes it. Perhaps there's still hope?
Have no fear, Branya. When a friend's in need, the Nameless will always be at their side. Yeah, after all, this guy here is a pretty good negotiator.
Thank you so much, both of you. I'm so sorry for dragging you into more trouble. While you're out looking for Topaz, I'll see if I can think of a strategy to deal with the situation. Best of luck. And stay safe.